Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you can see every time I upload a new video. So you guys, I'm literally here, pajama-fied. You guys, I'm right here in front of the tree. It's Christmas vibes, duh. But yeah, it's definitely Christmas AF out here. Like, you can see the vibes. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it says Merry Christmas back there on that little sign. How it looks though. Actually, that's how it looks. I don't know why I love the show. Guys, I got these dope new lights. You see the lights coming from here and here. I literally only spent $10 on some LED lights from Family Dollar. And it comes with this remote. And they work so freaking good. Like, so good. You guys, I hate bangs. I really hate them. And I don't know why I keep trying. I just keep trying to do this style because I want to like it so bad and I just don't like it every time. But yeah. Yeah, it's literally December 22nd. It's almost the 23rd. And I was gonna come back and bring you guys a story time. So this story time is about when I got into a car accident. And I almost lost my life. Do you see me? Lost my life. Like, I almost died. Like, literally. Venito over. I'm gonna just kick it in from the jump. So, basically, it was me and my kid's daddy. I haven't introduced him fully to you guys yet. Like, y'all don't know his name. So, I just say my kid's daddy until y'all really know his name and everything. Me and my kid's daddy. Wow. We in the car. We had a 2008 G6. Mind you, we broken up at this time, so somebody had texted my phone or whatever, and I was showing something on my screen. So when he texted my phone, it popped up on the screen, and basically my kid daddy got mad. So he got mad and stuff. So he like, I'm finna go. Ooh. So I'm like, oh, okay, I'll drop you off, basically. So he's like, no, I'll drop myself off and then you could just drive back. So I'm like, okay, whatever. This is usually what we do. So I'm like, all right, I'll drop you off, whatever. I get in the passenger seat, we pull off. We're driving up Harper Avenue. Now, mind you, we're supposed to be going to the right. We turn left. So we're going left. He talking junk, da-da-da-da-da, woo-woo-woo. I'm like, whatever, don't care what you're talking about, blah, blah, blah. So, we slowing down. We're coming up to an intersection. It's Dickerson and Harper. So, we slowing down. The light is red. So, we slowing down. Next you know, we get up to the light. It turned green before we can approach it. So, basically, we kept going type shit. You feel me? Like, we were slowing down, but it turned green. So, keep going. So, the light green, but whoever coming up Dickerson, like, this Detroit, people don't care about red lights. So the guy, he coming up Dickerson, he fly through the red light. And as we're arguing, like, all I do is turn to the left and I just see a car literally like, that just scared me so much. Oh my God. So yeah, anyway, Dre just walked in and just threw me off from my story. Back to my story. Anyway, he scared me. So yeah. As soon as we get to the intersection, I turn to the left. I see a car literally like right here next to us. So before I could say Dre, that's his name, Dre. Before I could say Dre, I'm like, Dre, like, boom, the man hit the car. So like, it was not his fault. It wasn't Dre's fault at all. Like, the fact that we were arguing just made it worse. But it's just like, you know, in the movies when you arguing, do you turn left and then a big semi truck coming, knocked it. That's exactly how I felt. So I'm. So I'm just like, bro, I'm seeing my life flash up in front of my eyes and the car is just doing donuts, like spinning. Boom, we hit a pole. Am I alive? Hello? That's how I felt. So I look around, I look at him, we look at each other, I'm like, my God, I'll be alive. Like, is how I was like, oh my God. So next I'm like, I can't move my legs. I broke 5 bones. I broke my ankle, my knee, my tibia, another T1, and then my wrist broke 5 bones. My nails are so ugly. You guys see this? My nail had broke all the way down here, and I had to let them grow back. So that's why my nails been like this. You know, anybody know me know this is so ghetto to me. Like,
bruh.
Yeah, I'm in the hospital. I'm cussing them out. I'm like, bro, I need some medication. My leg hurt. They like, okay, give me a moment. We gotta get your insurance.
Oh my God.
If you don't fucking process that, give me my goddamn medication. Like, I am in pain. Like, I never wanted a pill in my life until that moment. Like, bro, I was so sick. So basically I was like handicapped for 6 weeks. It was supposed to be more than that, but I really like was forcing myself to walk. Like, they was like, oh, between 3 and 6 weeks you could start back, you know, putting pressure on your legs, start back. Please, as soon as that time frame came around, I'm up, I'm falling, I'm trying. Like, I'm like, I'm about to learn how to walk. I'm not finna play. I gotta go back to work. Like, I gotta get this money. Like, coins don't wait on nobody. Stop playing with me. That's the story, y'all. Almost died. So it's like, after that, I really took this music stuff so much serious, like 100%, because I'm like, I could really die and I didn't become the super famous freaking rapper that I want to be. Like, I didn't become that model. I'm not an actress. I'm not doing anything. I'm almost dead. Like, what are you doing? So as I was able to walk, I went to work. I'm limping. I was working at StockX. I was limping. I'm like, I'm about to get this money, though. I don't care if I'm in here to lean on me when you're not strong. Yeah, I don't care. I needed all the coins, period. I was in there getting the money. Da-da-da. After that, I was like, okay. I know I'm not gonna last long, because I don't last long at jobs. Like, me and jobs just don't last long, because I'm just not meant for that. I'm meant to work for myself. I'm an entrepreneur. Like, yeah, so I'm like, okay, I'm not gonna last long. I was there for about 5 months, and then started dropping music. Why my lash look weird a little bit? Start dropping music. They know we hit them. Bow, dropped 44 bars. Got fired the next day. It's because every time I get a job and they figure out who I am, like my real life outside of working for somebody, they always start stalking my social medias and stuff. And then I got fired for something that had nothing to do with policies. They're like, oh yeah, you posted something on Instagram. What do Instagram got to do with you? Like, what does it have to do with you? Nothing. So that was irritating. But yeah, after that I dropped the video the day after I got fired. And then it was just from there. I just swiped me a flight, not fly a coach. Every fucking performance, I'd be lit. Like, 44 bars is my performance song. Like, that is my song. Turn up, guru, period. Make sure you look that up on all digital platforms. Lil Reeka, 44 bars. What is wrong with you? Like, you never seen me recording before. So guys, this little setup I did is actually working out so well. Like, it's crazy. But y'all gonna see all different parts of my house until I'm done, because I am a homeowner and I am under construction. Like, I was supposed to upload the homeowner vlogs, but I lost so much footage in these phones. Like, I don't know. But I'm gonna find some and post some stuff for y'all to see some befores and afters. So yeah, that's my little story time, how I almost died or whatever. And it just made me become the chick that I am today, because I would have just been out here and then who would have been dropping this fire ass music? Like, who? Right, that's what I'm saying. So make sure y'all tap in Instagram. 2 underscores Costa Rica, you already know, because I'm coast to coast with this shit. Pack only blow that cookie, keep me lifted like a car jack. No need to fabricate, man. This is all facts. Untouch man's knock him in his ball cap. State the truth. I ain't got a mother cap, and I'm still ready. Pink burner.